What if your body was secretly healing itself right now, but you didn't know which signs to look for? Today, I am revealing 5 unexpected signals that your insulin resistance might be reversing. And the 4th one is something that nobody talks about. Before I reveal these signs, remember that everyone's reversal journey is different. But if you're seeing any of these signals, something amazing might be happening inside of your body right now. Real quick, if you want to learn more science-based strategies and master your metabolic health, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. Also, you're gonna want to stick till the end because I am gonna share something that most health experts get wrong. Let's dive into our first sign: changes in your skin, particularly those dark patches known as acanthosis nigricans. Think of your skin as a billboard that is constantly advertising what's happening inside of your body. When you have insulin resistance, your insulin levels are very high. This happens because your pancreas is overcompensating, making more and more of this insulin in hopes to bring blood sugar down. Insulin is like a key that opens the door of many cells so glucose can go through the door and enter the cell. But it is this excess insulin that triggers something fascinating in your skin. The science here is incredible. Excess insulin activates IGF-1 receptors, essentially telling your skin cells to multiply faster than normal. This creates those dark, velvety patches known as acanthosis nigricans. Those patches usually appear around your neck area and armpits. And once excess insulin starts to diminish, those dark patches also go away. Now you may be asking yourself, how long does it take? Well, I can tell you from experience. Our members usually see these changes between 3 to 6 months after implementing the correct metabolic health strategies. One study in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology found that improvements in insulin sensitivity directly correlated with a lightening of those skin patches. So just keep in mind that if you're still seeing dark spots around your neck and armpits, it's likely that you still have insulin resistance. But if those are fading away, that's a great sign. Now, sign number 2. This is something that you can feel more than see. And I am talking about those incredible energy levels. Let me explain what's happening inside of your body in a way that will make perfect sense. Imagine your body like a busy city and glucose like delivery trucks carrying energy. When you're insulin resistant, it's like all the delivery warehouses are closed. The delivery trucks, glucose in this case, end up stuck in traffic, your bloodstream, causing chaos. This creates what I call the glucose roller coaster. First, you feel energized as all of these glucose is entering your body. But then as your body struggles directing that traffic jam, it overcompensates by secreting more and more insulin. When insulin has surpassed a certain threshold, your blood sugar comes crashing down. You know that 3 p.m. slump that makes you go for coffee or sugary treats? That's what's happening. That is your glucose roller coaster in action. But let me make a key point here. Insulin is not the problem. It's insulin resistance. But as your insulin sensitivity improves, it's like the warehouse doors start working properly again. The delivery trucks can smoothly enter and exit, keeping your blood sugar steady. The result? No more dramatic energy peaks and crashes. Just smooth, consistent energy throughout the day. Fascinating research done on mitochondrial function has shown that increases in insulin sensitivity improves mitochondrial function by up to 35%. And your mitochondria are like tiny power plants inside of your cells. When they work better, your energy becomes more stable. The third sign is perhaps the most exciting one: enhanced mental clarity. Your brain is an energy-hungry organ, consuming up to 20% of your body's glucose. But when you're insulin resistant, it's like trying to charge an electric car with a faulty charging station. Here's what's happening. As insulin sensitivity increases, your brain cells become more efficient at using glucose. Studies from the Journal of Alzheimer's Disease have shown that increased insulin sensitivity directly correlates with better memory and brain function. As a real-life example, one of my recent clients, a busy executive, told me that she stopped keeping post-it notes all over the place because her memory had dramatically increased in the last 3 months after following this program that was reversing her insulin resistance and was making her more insulin sensitive, meaning that her brain started working better. Once you start focusing on reversing insulin resistance and increasing your insulin sensitivity, you will feel the difference. It's like night and day. Now, sign number four is a game changer that surprises everyone. Transformed hunger signals. When you're insulin resistant, your hunger hormones are like a broken thermostat. They are constantly sending false alarms telling your brain that you are hungry. But as your insulin sensitivity improves, something amazing happens. Let's get scientific for a moment. Your body has two hunger hormones, leptin and ghrelin. Insulin resistance interferes with leptin signaling, making you feel hungry even when there's plenty of energy stored. As your insulin sensitivity improves, these hormones start working properly again. Think of it like restoring your body's natural appetite software to factory settings. Once this happens, you will notice that you're not as hungry in between meals and your brain is not constantly asking you to go to the pantry and to open the fridge. The final sign is one that everybody wants: changes in body composition, especially around the midsection. But in this case, it isn't just about looking good. It's actually about feeling and looking healthier. Here's a fascinating science. When your body is insulin resistant, it prefers to store fat around your organs, more specifically around the liver and pancreas. Think of it like your body using your organs as a storage lockers where it puts the excess energy. But here's the kicker. Your pancreas and your liver are not supposed to store large quantities of energy. They're not supposed to store fat. And the more of it that gets stored within the cells of your muscles, your liver, and your pancreas, the more insulin resistant that you become. But as your insulin sensitivity improves, something amazing happens. Your body actually starts using that energy that is being stored in places that are not meant to store fat, and those droplets of fat start diminishing in size, which makes insulin work correctly again. So once you feel that your genes start to feel looser, even if you don't see any changes on the scale, it means that your body composition is changing. It means that things are working better inside of your body. You're losing fat in the places that are not meant to store fat, which is extremely important for your health. So while you're watching for these signs, here are some actionable steps to support your body's healing journey. Number one, take 15-minute walks after meals. Number two, eat more fiber and less saturated fats. If you need guidance on how to do this, I'll leave a link below this video. Number three, ensure quality sleep, at least 7 to 8 hours every night. And number four, stay hydrated. At least half your body weight in ounces of water every single day. And here's the one thing that most experts get wrong about insulin resistance. They treat it as a permanent condition that only gets worse over time. But what research is showing is that insulin sensitivity is actually quite dynamic, and you can improve it with the right lifestyle interventions. We have 10 insulin resistance reversal tips that have worked for thousands of members in our program. I'll go ahead and leave the free link for you below this video. Meanwhile, I'm curious if you have seen any of the signs that I've talked about today. Please let me know in the comments below. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.